Thank you so much and welcome to tonight's concert. I'm very pleased to be here. I want to be sure to thank Joe Hagedorn, the president of the Society, and his wonderful staff of supporters who make it everything run smoothly and possible. Very nice to be here back in Minneapolis. I do have to tell you, I have a rather bad cold or allergy. I'm not sure what it is. So my voice is maybe a little raspy sometimes tonight. Just want to warn you of that. And I did plan on talking quite a bit in the concert, but I'm going to cut some of that short because it tends to make me cough. There we go, right on time. The program you're now about to hear is mostly centered around folk music. And even the pieces you're now going to hear by Schubert, while they're not exactly folk music, they're very folk-like. Schubert's songs are very much like folk music. And like all good folk songs, and certainly all good Schubert songs, the songs are either about love or suffering.
Thank you.
now, finishing up the first half, is a piece by a former teacher of mine, John Duarte, the great British guitar teacher and composer. Early in his life, he was a jazz guitarist, also became a classical guitarist, but was best known as composer and teacher. And I had the good fortune to study with him for 9 months. And while I did, we worked on this very piece, the English Suite. This was back in 1974, and the piece was written less than 10 years before that. So I'm very fortunate to have had that experience with him. And this piece is, I think, his most popular piece of many popular pieces that he's written. It's all based on English folk tunes. It's a charming piece, delight to play, and I hope to listen to, the English Suite.
Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone. We're going to continue with our folk music theme here with a piece of my own composition called Freedom Fantasie Number 2. It's based on the African-American spiritual, Sometimes I Feel Like a Motherless Child. It's one of a set of three freedom fantasies. Each of them a freewheeling set of variations on African-American spirituals. I wrote them in the early 90s, I think it was 1992. And in each of them, the theme appears in a different place in the piece. In one of them, it's in the beginning. Another one, it's in the middle. And in this one, the theme comes at the end. It starts off in a kind of a lonely place, as if you're in a very big canyon calling out, and you hear echoes in the canyon. And it slowly morphs into a passacaglia. And then that passacaglia morphs slowly into the theme, Sometimes I Feel Like a Motherless Child.
Thank you.
This next piece is a very special piece to me, and I think a special piece in the guitar repertoire. It's a piece by Richard Winslow called Variations on a Tune of Stephen Foster. Winslow was a mentor of mine in college at Wesleyan University, and he was a composer who quietly went about his business for many, many years. He taught for, I don't know, 40-some zillion years at Wesleyan. Didn't go off campus very much. He wrote an enormous amount of music and was content to just have it played on campus so that he could hear it and know whether it was good or not so good. And therefore he left behind, he passed away, by the way, in 2017, just shy of 100 years old. Lived a good long life, and left behind a treasure trove of an archive of compositions that needs to see the light of day, and there's work afoot at bringing that about. So he wrote this piece for me while I was still a student at Wesleyan in 1975, almost 50 years ago. This was a time when complexity held its sway in the classical music world, the contemporary world. Composers were writing more and more difficult, sometimes inaccessible music, complex, tremendous complexity. And Dick Winslow kind of wanted to buck that trend. But he even surprised himself with this piece, because he told me in a letter when he finished it, he said, I can't believe it, but I stuck to the three chords of Stephen Foster and didn't venture much beyond it, except just kind of in some places, especially towards the end where he gets a little wild. But still, he manages to be incredibly original in this piece. It's a remarkable piece. It's a theme and variations. The interesting thing is that it's divided into two parts, part one and part two. Originally, he suggested act one and act two. Dick was a very operatic-minded composer. He wrote a number of operas. And I thought act one and act two was a little too much for the lowly guitar. So he said, okay, let's just call it part one and part two. Well, each part ends with an interlocking set of three variations. The first one kind of ends with a bang. Be sure not to applaud there, because the silence between it and the second part is a very important part of it. The second part begins very quietly and very sparely. So that's a bit of a roadmap for you for Variations on a Tune of Stephen Foster by Richard Winslow. Oh, and there is a surprise at the end of the piece. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, and to finish the program tonight, a piece by Johann Caspar Mertz. Excuse me. Mertz was one of the great 19th century composers for the guitar. He is represented on my newest album, which I think Kyle mentioned to you at the beginning of the program. It's an album called Charms to Soothe, with music of Sor Giuliani Mertz Rigondi and a composer you've probably never heard of named Leonard Schultz, all from the early 19th century. Beautiful music, music to soothe our savage breasts in a time of great trouble and chaos. This piece goes right along with the folk music theme of the program. Mertz was Austro-Hungarian, and the piece features many Hungarian rhythms, choirs, dances, the cymbalum, which is like the hammered dulcimer. It's a very exciting piece, and I hope you enjoy Hungarian Fantasie, one of the last pieces he wrote.
Thank you.
Thank you. You've just been a delightful audience. I'm really enjoying playing for you. I'd like to play you Antonio Carlos Jobim's Felicidade, arranged by Ron Dionce and edited by yours truly. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.